Hello everyone, I'm Vikramaditya here. I'm an SAP architect, and for any SAP HANA related training, you can contact me on jhsinfotech@gmail.com. This would be the mail ID in which I'll be responding to you. And going ahead, in this session I'm going to discuss about the concept of row storage versus the column storage of data, which is a very important topic. This is a very important topic of row storage into column storage of the data. So I'm going to explain you what exactly is the significance of row storage versus the column storage. Let me tell you before starting off this concept that most of the databases as of now which we make use of in our day-to-day activities in an enterprise make use of row storage, and column storage is something which will be rarely used. But having said that, row storage is very optimal for making use of entries. For example, you are making day-to-day activities and you are doing day-to-day activities and you are making entries at the day-to-day basis, then it will be stored in the row storage. Row storage would be better in that scenario. But whereas in data warehousing concepts, you only access the data. We load the data once in a while and we always access the data. There's no possibility of entering the data or creating data on our own. So in that scenario, column storage would be better. So column storage is better for read-only access, and row storage is better for manipulation of data. So this is the ground rule that we have here. And let us move ahead with the concept of the further concept of row storage and column storage. So column store, basically SAP HANA makes use of both the concepts of row storage as well as the column storage, and giving more significance to the column storage. Column store introduction, we are going to discuss that. Column store data model, emulation of column store in row data, row storage, in row store. Column store optimization, experiment and results and conclusion as well. So we have these two types of storage, row storage and column storage. Normally in any of the databases, what exactly happens is the entire data is stored in a table. When the data is stored in table, each field will have a particular column. So these are all linked. Let's say most of the times it will be making use of a primary key. So whenever we make an entry, and let's say we have five fields here, date, store, product, customer and price, and let's say we have entered only three records, we have entered only three columns. If remaining two are empty, then it's just going to stay like that. So there's not, I mean, like those records will be blank, those values will be blank obviously. So in this row storage, no matter how many columns, for example you are making the entries only for three columns, but still empty columns are created for customer and price as well, because initially you are entering the data only for date, store, product. Customer and price also will be blank, and a record will be created. So there is a blank record that gets created here. So we are creating lot of blanks here in the row storage. If you are not entering the entire row. So we have seen in many business scenarios wherein we are not going to enter the entire data. For example, you are entering the address, phone number, email ID. So you have alternate phone numbers, you have alternate email IDs, so which we normally skip. So when we skip that, which is not mandatory, then empty column or empty field will be created there. In the table. So that creates a problem in the sense, like, we have unnecessarily wastage of memory. So in column storage it's not like that. So if we have entered some data for a particular value, say for example we are entering the data for date, store and product, and we are not entering the data for customer and price, then these two tables are not touched at all. So these are individual tables wherein we have data stored in these three tables, and these two tables have not been touched. So this is how the data column storage works. In row store data are stored in the disk tuple by tuple. Let's say this one row is a tuple. The data is stored as a one row. no matter even if you enter one record, then the entire row is created. So where in column store data, data is stored in the disk column by column. So disk column by column, this is a disk, disk column by column is what the storage happens in column store. So row store versus column store is what we are discussing now. Most of the queries does not process all the attributes of a particular relation. For example, the query select CNAME and C address from custom, customs as C, where C dot region is equal to Mumbai. This is a simple syntax that we have. Only process three attributes of the relation customer. So we are extracting only CNAME and C address based on C region, that is Mumbai. But the customer relation can have more than three attributes. Obviously, in that particular table, we might have, you know, 20 or 30 attributes, but still we are accessing only three. So column stores are more input output efficient for read only queries. Remember this, underline this word, column stores are efficient only for read only queries, as they read only those attributes which are accessed by a query. So since we are accessing the data, column based will be more optimal. So row store and column store, so easy to add or modify a record. Row storage easy to add or modify a record, might read in unnecessary data. Column store only need to read in relevant data. Tuple writes require multiple accesses. So column stores are suitable for read mostly, read intensive, large data repositories. So when we have huge data to be read, then we are going to make use of column store. But when you are want to add or modify any records on a regular basis, we would always prefer row storage. This is what I am again and again repeating, because this is a very important concept that we need to differentiate between the row store and column store. Might read in unnecessary data. So this is, there is a lot of unnecessary data here, but tuples writes requires only multiple accesses, and wherever there is a required data, only that data is data is entered. So why column store? So can be significantly faster than row stores for some applications. Fetch only required columns for a query, better cache effects, better compression, similar attributes values within a column, but can be slower for other applications. For OLTP, online transaction processing with many row inserts, it will be slower, the column storage will be slower, because in OLTP, as you know, we do transactions. When we do the transactions, we do record by record entries, which is not comparatively significant for column storage. So we don't recommend column store in that case. So long war between the column store and row store camps. This paper tries to give a balanced picture of advanced and disadvantages after adding, subtracting a number of optimizations for each approach. So we are looking at that. So standard relational logical data model, say for example we have employee and we have department. So there are two tables here, logical data models, name, age, salary, department is in one table, and department name and floor name are there in another table. Table is what, it's a collection of projection set of columns. So horizontally partitioned into segments with segment identifier. So we do have the segments here. So to answer queries, projections are joined using storage keys and join indexes. Storage keys within a segment, every data value of every column is associated with a unique key. So that is a surrogate key. So values are different columns with matching keys, primary keys, belong to the same logical row. So what exactly happens? I'm going to show the same thing what I'm talking about in the diagrammatical way, which will give you a more clear picture. So join indexes T1 and T2 are projections on T. T1 and T2 are T. M segments in T1 and N segments in T2. So join index from T1 to T2 is a table of the form. Segment ID in T2. Storage key in segment S. So each row in join index matches corresponding row in T1. So join indexes are built such that T could be efficiently constructed from T1 and T2. So what exactly we are doing is, there is one table called T1, there is another table called T2, and we are giving a projection as T. So similar to what we have normally done in database tables. So there is VBAK, VBAP, and we created a view which combines data from both. So this is what we can normally do in join indexes. So here we have a pictorial understanding of what exactly we can do in the join indexes, where we have the data store data coming from two different attribute views, and we have construct employee from EMP1 and EMP3 using join index on EMP3. So we have two tables now, EMP1 and EMP3, and we are getting the join, making use of join index, we are getting the data into the final table. So we have compression, traits input output for CPU, increased column store opportunities, higher data value locality in column stores. Techniques such as run length encoding far more useful. For schemes, null suppression, dictionary encoding, run length encoding, a bit vector encoding, and heavyweight schemas. So these are the schemes that we have, we can better ignore as of now. So query execution, we have select, projection, join, aggregation, sort. These are all the options that we can have on the column storage data. So decompresses, converts compressed column into uncompressed representation, which can be possible in the column storage. Mask, bit string, B, projection, CS, emit only those values whose corresponding bits are I. Concat, combines one or more projections sorted in the same order in a single projection. Permute, permutes a projection according to the ordering defined by a join index. Bit string operations, operators, BAN, bitwise, and BOR, bitwise or P0 complement. Okay, these are the big string operators. So now here, row versus row store versus column store, we have how much of the buzz around the column stores is marketing hype. Do you really need to buy Sybase IQ? Okay, this is something which is related to a normal discussion, but let's stick to our HANA related row wise column storage discussion. So now the simplistic view about the difference in storage layout leads to that one, that one can obtain the performance with benefits of a column store using a row store by making some changes to the physical structure of the row store. So they are like, this changes can be vertically partitioning. So when there is a data which is already stored in the row store, this data can be converted into column store by making use of vertical partitioning, using index only plans, using materialized views. So vertical partitioning. So full vertical partitioning of each relation, each column I, physical table. This can be achieved by adding integer position columns to every table. Adding integer positions is better than adding primary key. So problems. So position, space, and disk bandwidth. Header for every tuple for the space wastage. So we have a couple of problems here when we go for vertical partitioning. The process is that, and the problem is this. So when we do the vertical partitioning, so basically the row storage will be similar to what we see on the left side, and when we do the vertical partitioning, it will look something which is on the right side. So index only plans, so add B plus stream index for every table column. Plans never access the actual tuples on disk, so headers are not stored, so per tuple overhead is less. Separate indices may require full index scan, which is slower. So select, we have the select statement here, composite index with age, salary, key headers. So we have index only plans. So index only plans is something which we are actually making use of index kind of a thing, wherein we have all the mappings. So wherein there is something which is very common. So let's say there is a last name which is common for multiple people, so we can store it once and make use of it again and again. So index only plans is similar to that. Materialized views, we have materialized views here. Materialized views when we have constructed facts. These are the different models that we have for PAX models and star schema benchmarks, invisible joins. So these are the things that we have in the further discussion. So but what I discussed related to column storage and row storage till now is more than enough for us to understand the concept of how column and row storage works.